Have you been diagnosed with depression and struggle with sadness?
Maybe you're scared of being criticized.
Loss of interest,
aches and pain.
Always thinking something terrible.
Ask your doctor about Effexor XR.
Ask your doctor about Cymbalta.
Talk to your doctor about Zoloft.
So talk to your healthcare professional.
Get your doctor today.
Your doctor.
Tell your doctor.
Contact your doctor immediately.
Talk with your doctor.
Più di 40 anni fa, le autorità della psichiatria si sono incontrate a Porto Rico per programmare la loro visione del futuro.
We see a developing potential for nearly a total control of human emotional status, mental functioning and will to act.
I loro piani: creare entro il 2000 una serie di psicofarmaci che fossero in grado di regolare ogni aspetto del comportamento umano.
I was diagnosed with depression and put on Paxil.
ADD, and I was prescribed Ritalin.
General anxiety disorder. Prescribed Zoloft.
Bipolar disorder, and I take lithium.
PTSD, Zoloft.
I was on Paxil.
And they placed me on Zoloft.
They gave me Adderall.
I was prescribed Siptimil.
Tegretol.
Lexapro. Debaco.
Stelazine.
Adderall.
Concerta. Lorazine.
Prozac. Lorazepam.
Effexor. Clonazepam.
Ritalin. Dexafetamine.
Paxil. Xylert.
Prozac. Adderall.
Elavil.
Depakote. Wellbutrin. Seroquel. Etc. Etc.
100 milioni di persone a livello mondiale assumono psicofarmaci. Com'è potuto accadere? Gli psichiatri li hanno convinti che erano malati.
They want you to think you're diseased from birth, and that all those experiences of life, childhood and adolescence and teenage years and adulthood, and being a senior citizen, that these are all various stages of disease.
Because let's face it, we've all been depressed at one time. We've all been anxious at one time. These are normal emotions that we feel.
Every emotional and spiritual problem is reduced to a label.
And of course, all of those diseases require pharmaceutical treatments. This is big, big business.
Mentre danno luogo ad un proficuo guadagno sostenendo di essere professionisti medici, gli psichiatri confesseranno liberamente che la loro professione è priva di scienza.
We don't really have any specific blood tests or other tests that are definitive for any mental illness whatsoever.
It would be neat if it would become much more scientific.
Well, if you go to my office and you tell me that you're depressed, there's nothing and no blood sample or whatever, no tests.
There are not current available tests to verify your diagnosis.
I don't use any tests.
You do not have a test to say, well, this is this disorder and this is the best medication for this disorder.
For many years we thought we had the tests nailed down, but it turned out that they weren't of any value.
If you don't know what's causing the symptoms, then to give somebody something to alleviate the symptoms is close to impossible.
By the time a drug's approved and it hits the general population, we don't know even 50% of the side effects that are involved with that drug.
And these pills cause heart attacks and liver problems and immune system problems and lots of other medical problems. So you're playing with fire.
Ogni giorno i farmaci psicotropi causano gravi reazioni avverse. E mentre gli psichiatri e le case farmaceutiche sono a conoscenza dei danni degli psicofarmaci che vendono, i loro clienti ignari vengono lasciati a soffrirne le conseguenze.
Everything became worse. Each mood swing was worse.
He would have chronic headaches, chronic nausea, not feeling good.
She was very agitated. Very, very jumpy.
She was having horrible hallucinations.
Her personality was disintegrating.
Once he started on that drug, the cloud stayed over him. It got darker and darker.
He thought there wasn't anything worth living to kill himself. That was not me. That was the drugs.
At least I would like to have said, I love you. I didn't get a chance to do that.
Oltre a rovinare decine di persone giornalmente, si stima che ogni mese gli psicofarmaci uccidono circa 3.000 persone. Ma la devastazione umana non avrebbe mai raggiunto cifre così alte se gli psichiatri non avessero lavorato in stretta collaborazione con le case farmaceutiche per promuovere i loro psicofarmaci ai dottori di tutto il mondo. Oggi il 70% di tutti gli psicofarmaci viene prescritto da comuni medici. Come è stato possibile farlo? Marketing.
It's about creating a good story that uses science, that convinces a physician
to think about writing a prescription.
This is not science. This is incredibly effective marketing. It has nothing to do with science.
They use what I call statistical contortionism. Basically just skew the numbers, make everything look fantastic, you hide the bad numbers.
They're learning every trick in the book. They're evolving into efficient marketing machines. And it's working.
There's definitely an unholy alliance between psychiatry and pharmaceutical sales. That's a marriage made in heaven.
They're like conjoined twins. They're joined at the wallet.
E con 374 disturbi presenti nel manuale diagnostico psichiatrico e altri in arrivo, gli affari stanno aumentando. Le case farmaceutiche hanno ampliato la loro lista di psicofarmaci da 44 del 1966 ai 174 di oggi. Il guadagno lordo proveniente dalla vendita dei 5 psicofarmaci più venduti è maggiore del guadagno nazionale lordo di più della metà dei paesi sulla Terra. In totale, l'industria psichiatrica raccoglie in un anno 330 miliardi di dollari. Come è potuto accadere tutto ciò? È una storia di inganni che potrebbe essere difficile da credere, ma fatale da ignorare.
We took him to a psychiatrist, and within a matter of minutes, yeah, she's ADHD, and here's your drug.
Went on the Medicaid, and 5 minutes later, he was on Zyprexa.
He saw the psychiatrist who prescribed the medicine for 20 minutes.
The guy didn't even look at her. He talked to her a little bit. Now, how can you tell if somebody's ADHD or not ADHD from just a few minutes talking to her?
Next thing I know, I'm getting handed a handful of Xanax. That's how easy it is to get these drugs. Just so easy. It's just passed to me like candy. That's simple.
If a person were to walk in off the street, sat down with a psychiatrist, the chances of him being prescribed a drug before he were to leave the office, I would have to put it at 100%.
Psychiatrists prescribe drugs. They might have different ways of diagnosing, they might have different ways of interacting with a patient, but it's rare to find a psychiatrist that uses no drugs.
The psychiatrists today are, in quotes, admitting they can't cure these mental illnesses, and they're therefore going to manage your illness by using a drug.
50 years ago, a person who was going through a divorce would have relied on family, friends, clergy, and even the family doctor to a certain extent for conversation to work through the issue. They certainly wouldn't have been medicated.
Era prima dell'era degli psicofarmaci. Gli psichiatri, occupando il livello più basso della professione medica, lavoravano quasi esclusivamente nelle istituzioni mentali. Senza nessuna cura, c'erano poche possibilità che fossero rispettati dal pubblico ed apparissero come veri medici.
Psychiatrists had for years been on the fringe of medicine. Typically, the standard doctor internist would have very low regard for psychiatrists because it was understood not to be a very clear science or art.
Psychiatrists wanted to be viewed as physicians, as doctors. And in order to be viewed as physicians and doctors, the people they dealt with had to be viewed as patients. And if doctors dealt with diseases, then their patients had to be diseased.
Psychiatrists had a wonderful opportunity, they felt, to become respected in the eyes of their peers. They raced to create a whole diagnostic book called the DSM, the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual, which was created by consensus.
A group of psychologists and psychiatrists get together, and if they have made common observations, they have a vote, and they now classify a new disease. And they give it a number, and it graduates into the DSM classification.
And it's a dangerous book. It's a book that has many disorders that could apply to any one of us, because the disorders are not real medical diseases. And it's things that apply to nearly all of us at times. Are you afraid of meeting new people? Are you afraid to speak in front of a large crowd of people? Does it make you nervous to go and to talk to your boss about a complaint?
You can invent a mental disorder based on a checklist of symptoms, and that is exactly how the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual, the billing bible for psychiatry, works.
Fin dalla prima edizione del DSM nel 1952, il numero di diagnosi è costantemente aumentato. da un sottile opuscolo di 130 pagine che elencava 106 cosiddetti disturbi mentali, il DSM è diventato un tomo di 886 pagine. È soltanto usando questo libro che gli psichiatri possono fare le diagnosi, somministrare farmaci e addebitare i servizi prestati. Infatti, l'industria psichiatrica attualmente usa il DSM per raccogliere oltre 72 miliardi di dollari di fondi assicurativi di privati e statali.
The DSM is used to diagnose and then give a label, and the label is used for billing purposes. That's how they get paid.
You have to have a term in the diagnostic and statistical manual in order to then call it a disease and treat it as a disease and write a prescription for it.
And so because they can vote it in, they can create, and then the drug industry can just take over and market their drugs for those new disorders.